And good morning, everyone. Welcome to This Day. It is the last day of August, believe it or not. August 31st, another warm day out. I'll tell you about the weather in just a moment. On our show today, we are going to get an update from United. And then we have Dr. Andrew Chang here today from California Proton Cancer Therapy Center. He's going to talk about treating breast cancer. Jose Vergara, who is on the El Toro Water District Board, is here. His topic today is a proposition that is coming up that's going to be on the November ballot. That's Proposition 3. It's going to be a water bond measure. He's going to talk all about that. And we also have Brian Rott here today and Jared Morgan from CartMart, which is, of course, right on the other side of the freeway. All right, meetings. There is one, and that is the GRF Special Mobility and Vehicles Committee meeting. This is dealing primarily, I think, the only topic is the bus system. We're going to bring that to you live after this show if you're watching us in the morning at 9:30. Now, as far as the weather goes, we get this high pressure system that's out there. This is why we're getting warmer weather right now. The interesting thing is this high pressure system is actually off our coast. It's located, the center of it, maybe 200 miles off the California-Mexico border. That's really unusual. They're usually inland. They're usually sitting over Arizona and that sort of thing. And that's why we're also getting this onshore breeze associated as well. And although the temperatures have gone up, it's not really hot. So here we go, about 86, 87 today, tomorrow, and Sunday. There we're going to drop it down, getting those morning clouds coming back in Monday and Tuesday. So at least that's what's in the forecast. And so this warmer weather right now isn't too bad, and that's because of where that high pressure system, but we all know when we get into September and October, that's when we start getting those Santa Ana winds towards the end of September and into October. Let's look around the state, and mild to warm around the state this weekend. The coastal communities, as you go down, cooler, of course, the North Coast, and getting warmer as we get all the way down to San Diego, and the whole coastal communities and an inland by about 20 miles will have that morning fog and then giving way to sun. Tahoe, look at that, 80 degrees, and Yosemite, 83 degrees. So nice up there. Beautiful locally here at Arrowhead, 77, and Palm Springs, 105. Those are your averages for about the next 3 days. So nice weather around the state. All right, we'll be back in just a moment.
Did you know there are over 400,000 seniors in Orange County today? So where does a senior or family caregiver go for information and resources? You can turn to the Answers Guide, published by the Council on Aging Southern California. Answers is full of articles and resources to help you navigate the aging experience. You can pick up your free copy today at the clubhouse nearest you or at the Social Services Office. The Council on Aging, helping seniors remain healthy, connected, and protected.
Along this journey, there are stories of hope and victory with BreastLink. And we have today, Sandy.
Yes, I have had victory in this last year. It's been a hard journey, but an amazing one because I was cared for by the best doctors at BreastLink. The doctors, the staff, everyone there, consummate professionals. They did everything that needed to be done so that I could do my job and just rest and get better. It's like they wrapped me in bubble wrap so I could do the hard work of getting better, but they took care of everything else.
Kiana Lee. Today we're talking with Dr. Christine Chung. Today's topic is gum disease. Doctor, what do we need to know about gum disease?
Mom. Oh, I'm sorry. Gum disease is an infection of the tissue that support and surround your teeth. It's a major cause of tooth loss in adults, but it's an easy fix.
Thank you, doctor. So don't wait, people. Come on in and get your 7-day dental smile.
I'm coming for you, cancer. With California Protons, I now have the technology and expertise to fight with unmatched precision. I'll zero in and wear you down with radiation, millimeter by millimeter. You won't weaken me. I'll spare my tissues and protect myself against future threats. Cancer, you're history. I'm looking to the future.
And Dr. Andrew Chang is with us right now from the California Protons Cancer Therapy Center. Welcome back.
Thank you, Ken. It's always great to be here.
Yeah, good to see you back again.
See you as well.
And, you know, we just saw that spot there,
right,
dealing with breast cancer, and that is what our topic is today. I know in the past you have touched on it, but we're going to go into more detail. So what are some of the advances in medicine that have come along for treating breast cancer?
Well, fortunately, one of the things that we're starting to see now is we're finding breast cancer at an earlier and earlier stage. And I think that's because the last few decades, we've done a really good job of encouraging women to get screened with the annual and regular mammograms.
Now, when we talk about the screening, when is the right age? I mean, I remember, you know, it used to be after 40, maybe once every few years,
yes,
and after 50, you know, more and more. Is that sort of the consensus still, or has that changed?
Yes, that still is indeed the consensus for recommendations, but it does vary a little bit depending upon a woman's family history.
Right.
So a woman who has a lot of sisters or aunts and grandmothers and mothers, if there's a history of cancer that runs in the family, we do encourage the woman to get screened potentially even earlier than that.
Okay, and they have the mammograms, and they also have a little bit more advanced screening.
That's
as well.
Correct, yes. One of the things that was difficult to do for younger women with mammograms before is the younger a woman is, the more difficult it is to find breast cancer on a mammogram.
Okay.
So one of the things that people are starting to look at is potentially the use of MRIs for breast cancer detection. And we're starting to see that can be very helpful in some women's cases as well.
Okay, and that might be something you use if you know there's a history.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
So let's talk about the proton therapy. How does that benefit breast cancer? And when is that the right treatment?
So that's a great question. In the treatment of breast cancer, typically it involves multiple different specialties together. Mm-hmm. And oftentimes there's surgery involved, as well,
right,
as potentially for chemotherapies or hormonal therapies that come along with it. Proton radiation is a form of radiation that allows us to pinpoint a little bit better where we're giving that radiation. And so for women who have had surgery and will be requiring radiotherapy, protons could potentially give less radiation to the other breast, the rest of the normal breast tissue, and potentially, especially if the breast cancer is on the left side, avoiding or eliminating radiation to the heart and the lungs that sit underneath it.
Okay, and that's because the proton therapy is pinpointing,
correct, that's correct. It's like that example I give of a standard radiation beam, like a shotgun, hitting everything in the area. Proton radiation is like a target rifle, allows us to pinpoint where we're giving that radiation. One of the things we've seen with women is, as we get better and better at curing breast cancer, women are living longer and longer, and we start seeing the long-term side effects of that breast cancer treatment. Especially for women with breast cancer on the left, one of the things we see from radiation is they can have a higher chance of developing heart disease, because that heart sits just right behind that left breast.
Right.
And with proton therapy and being able to pinpoint it, we're often able to minimize or completely eliminate that radiation to the heart. And so the idea is, as we cure the cancer, preventing the woman from getting that heart disease or other disease in the future.
As far as the therapy goes, would it be done in conjunction with chemotherapy as well, or that just depends?
That also depends on the aggressiveness of the tumor.
Okay.
Likewise, whether or not a big surgery or a smaller surgery, what we call a mastectomy or a lumpectomy, is done, is a little bit of personal choice from the women, as well as a little bit of how is the tumor situated in the breast and the size of the tumor in the breast. And depending upon all those factors, we would, as a team, decide surgery is good, chemotherapy is good, hormone therapy is good, radiation is good, and sometimes one or two or all three of the combinations.
Okay, now with the proton therapy, is it a quicker process? Is it something that is ongoing for weeks compared to standard radiation?
Yeah. So in general, the radiation treatment is the same.
Okay.
And so most women, when they're coming for radiotherapy, whether standard radiation or proton, it's a daily treatment, Monday through Friday.
Okay.
Typically anywhere from about 4 to 6 weeks of that treatment. Now, there are some interesting trials that are starting to come out of right now, looking at, since protons can be very focused, can we compress that several weeks of radiation down into just a few weeks? I'm currently running a trial, actually, in the United States that opened up multiple centers throughout the United States looking
now,
at that.
Would that be, let's just say hypothetically, because mm-hmm. I don't know. Let's say over the course of 8 weeks,
sure.
somebody does that 4 days a week or twice a week or whatever, they're still getting the same amount of therapy. It just, you can do one in the morning, one in the afternoon. Is that sort of what's being
looked at? Exactly. That's one way of doing it, doing okay. two treatments a day. So some in the morning, some in the afternoon to shrink that several weeks down. Another way of doing it is saying, can we just give more radiation on each day's treatment so that you can do the whole treatment in, say, 10 treatments instead of 30 treatments? And that can compress the amount of time a woman needs to come for radiotherapy.
Very good. That yeah. would be very good news.
Yes, yes. And we're starting to see very good early results from that as a result.
What about working with their primary care physician? Mm-hmm. You know, from there, of course, and they're going to be if there is breast cancer, if they detect it or they think there might be a possibility, you know, they're referred to somebody, a specialist in there. Would that be directly to you folks, or once they get to an oncologist, then from there they would work with them and say, we want to look into the proton therapy?
Sure. It can actually come from either way.
Okay.
We do have women coming from their primary care physicians, but the majority of them are patients who have already gone to see a cancer specialist. Typically a surgeon, so mm-hmm. a breast cancer surgeon who has taken out the cancer and diagnosed it, will then say, you're somebody who potentially could benefit from radiotherapy. Proton therapy may be an option for you.
Okay, what about if they don't need surgery? I guess what I'm asking is, if they're finding a very small mm-hmm. amount of cancer in there, can they go directly using proton therapy, or it has to be used in conjunction with surgery?
So at this current stage, people are evaluating that, whether one can do radiotherapy instead of surgery. But for the most part, most women would benefit mostly from a surgery first prior to any radiotherapy. And so generally we would say, okay. no, we should get the surgery and not proton itself. Unlike something like prostate cancer, where one could do proton radiation
right,
instead.
That's what I'm, yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Breast cancer is one we tend to say surgery is the cornerstone treatment for breast cancer.
All right, very good. Mm-hmm. Great to have you on here today.
You're welcome.
And if you are interested in finding out more, you can go to californiaprotons.com and that will give you more information. Their number, they're down in the San Diego area. That's their direct number, 858-549-7400. And you can find out more information there. But next month we're going to have, did you say Dr. Rossi
yep,
on?
Yep, Dr. Carl okay. Rossi, our medical director and world expert on prostate cancer.
All right, very good. Always good to see you, doctor.
Pleasure.
You take care.
Thank
and
you,
and we'll
yourself.
Be right back.
Bye-bye.
At El Toro Pharmacy, your health needs and your quality of life is our top priority. We can be trusted with all your prescription needs, delivered free to your doorstep. Call us to have your prescription transferred. We will take care of everything, no hassle to you. We are a full-service pharmacy carrying all your over-the-counter medicines at competitive prices. And we offer complete diabetic care and your immunization requirements, too. Under new management, come visit us in Moulton Plaza. El Toro Pharmacy will never be undersold, and we offer the finest after-sale services.
When other dealers say no, Capistrano Toyota says,
yes, we can.
Low payments? Yes, we can. Low financing for all types of credit? Yes, we can. Capistrano Toyota features 10 acres of new and certified pre-owned Toyotas, plus many used cars priced below $10,000. When other dealers say no, Capistrano Toyota says,
yes, we can.
Exit the 5 freeway at Camino Capistrano.
Number one choice for wood flooring and more is LA Carpet.
Now during their two-day sale, visit their showroom now and get 65% off wood flooring, laminate, and waterproof flooring.
Plus, get 5-year, 0% financing.
LA Carpet, number one for you.
Trust the experts at Universal Carpet for all your flooring needs. Now get 50% off pet stain resistant and hyperallergenic carpet, porcelain tile, wood laminate and waterproof flooring, and complete kitchen and bath remodels. Plus get 5-year 0% financing, including free installation and free furniture removal. Our convenient showrooms are just minutes away in Irvine and Huntington Beach, or call 866-402-2747 for our free in-home shopping service. Universal Carpet, the low price leader for over 20 years.
Get out and live your life with the Buzz Around XL travel scooter from Golden. The Buzz Around is fun to drive with a tight indoor turning radius, so you can go just about anywhere. It's also so easy to charge and offers all-day range, so you can go further. The Buzz Around even has more leg and foot room for all-day driving comfort. Be safe with the XL's ultra-bright LED headlight. Plus, the Buzz Around XL can be easily taken apart into several lightweight pieces. See for yourself just how easy and affordable mobility freedom can be.
And Don Tibbetts is with me right now from the United Board. Welcome, Don. How are you?
I'm fine, Ken. Thank you.
Good to see you today. And you got several things that you're going to go over.
Yeah, I'd kind of like to review everything we've done this year in most of our areas, starting out with our waistlines. I've mentioned that before. As of this date, we've completed 118 different buildings. And we hope to increase that number next year.
All right, very good.
And next item was pushmatic panels. I've talked about quite often. Last week, we've completed 207 for this year. And add that to last year, we've done a total of a little over 300 and something. This is our third year. We've got a great contract with the company, and we might increase that. We'll wait and see.
Okay, yeah, because I know there's still a lot more to go, right?
Oh, yes. We've only done the partial number. Solar panels, we've started that with the company JCI, and we are waiting for some figures from JCI, or they might have come in this week, I'm not sure. And we're going to look at those and see if we have saved the amount of money that was projected to be saved.
Okay.
And hopefully we have, but staff's working on it right now. Another item besides the pushmatic panels, we have outside major panels, and we had to appropriate some money to replace two of the large ones that were destroyed by moisture over the years.
Okay.
For some reason, they were placed too low on the side of the building, and after 50 years, the sprinklers put a lot of moisture in there.
Yeah.
They burned up.
All right, so got to replace those for sure. Now, what's this fuzz buzz?
Well, that's something new that just came out. We are looking at these things. They are water leak indicators. And they're individually, they only cost $4 or $5. But if we did it as all of United, it'd be $145,000, which is too much for us right now.
Okay.
So individual residents can do it on their own. They can go over to Home Depot and buy a couple of them, put them around the water heater or faucet.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about now. Yeah, they're like a little disc type thing.
Yes.
Okay, right. Now I understand. All right, you approved a supplemental appropriation from the contingency fund, and this is for concrete work.
Yes, cul-de-sac 38 sunk a little bit.
Okay.
Over the years, just like lawn bowling sunk a little. The ground at that time has given way, and it has to be repaired, so we approved the emergency fund to fix it, and it should be done within the week, if not already completed.
All right, very good. And of course, the ongoing lighting along the walkways.
There's two points of view on that. Some of us say, well, there's enough walkway lights, and others say, no, they can't see. Others say you put them in, it's going to shine in our bedrooms. So it's controversial, but we're looking into it. There's two points of view. We have hired an energy consultant on call. We're going to give the problem to him and see what he comes up with. And so there'll be more information coming on that soon.
All right, and then finally, dry rot, but in this case, you're talking about decks.
Well, the dry rot is always here, and we've looked into it a lot of times. A lot of the problems started when the buildings were were not finished properly. They only painted one side of a header board, for example, and the other side is where the dry rot started. Now we are priming both sides, and it's really cutting down.
Right.
And
that's, really, that's very good.
Because it really spreads quickly.
Yeah, it does.
And one other item I just added, I got email from Ernesto, and on these wheelchair lifts on two-story buildings, a lot of people wanted them, and they were, so we did some work on them. As of today or yesterday, we have 29 lifts in United, and we will install them, or we can, we will approve their installation if people want them, but they had to pay for it.
Okay.
And they're about $50,000 each. But some people have come up with that money and put them in. Once they are installed, they become the property of United, so we will maintain them indefinitely.
Okay. All right. Very good. Anything else you'd like to add for today?
No, that's about it.
All right. Thank you for coming by. We appreciate it.
My pleasure.
And folks, if you want to find out more about this, a lot of this stuff you can find out online and through Granicus and things like that.
Yes.
So they're all there for you to look at.
All right.
Good to see you, sir.
My pleasure, Ken.
You take
always.
Care. Thank we'll
you.
Be right back.
We all know there's no place like home. You want to stay in your own home, but day-to-day tasks are getting more difficult to manage. ActiCare is the solution. We are the trusted care partner in your community with 5-star reviews. You've taken care of others all your life. Now is the time to let us help you. In-home care is a safe and effective way to help you remain living independently in the comfort of your own home.
ActiCare, responsive in-home care. Your first day is free.
You may know AgeWell for delivering life-saving Meals on Wheels to homebound seniors, but did you know they keep seniors active and engaged at 10 modern centers? Serve nutritious congregate meals amid friendly surroundings, transport seniors safely to and from appointments, and provide much-needed equipment and other essential services. Now, this vital nonprofit organization needs your support to sustain its mission. This is AgeWell Senior Services. Won't you make it yours?
Hiring a realtor you trust is the first step in selling your home. Selecting an escrow company that can safeguard your money and personal information throughout the transaction is the next step. Escrow Options will guarantee the safety of your personal information and funds from the risks of wire fraud and cyber theft. Choose the escrow company that works for you. Escrow Options Group, protecting consumer assets in escrow since 2005.
Maxi Comfort from Golden is the most comfortable lift recliner in the world. Its patented technology glides smoothly into a variety of positions not found on most recliners. Everyone loves the programmable auto drive control. You can lift and recline, watch TV or sleep, and enjoy the feeling of weightlessness in zero gravity. Made by American workers and backed by the industry's best warranties. Feel relaxed in a Maxi Comfort lift recliner. Contact your local Golden retailer today.
All right, my friend Jose Vergara is here today with the El Toro Water District. And today, sir, we are talking about really one topic. And we're talking about a proposition that will be on the November ballot, Proposition 3. And over the years, we've had some water bond acts, and this is another one that's coming up. So maybe kind of give us a background. I know one was approved, I thought, like maybe 3-4 years ago. I might be wrong on that.
Yeah, well, thank you, Ken, first for giving me the chance to come here. Getting close to elections, so people start asking questions.
Yeah.
I have friends who ask me, what is this and how to vote? First, and I want a disclaimer, as an elected official, as a citizen, I cannot tell anybody how to vote. This is
right.
a conscious effort that everybody has to do. And as a friend, I also do the same. Tell them this is your own decision.
Yeah.
I do want to educate people in something I know.
Sure.
And this
sure.
is the case, for example, in this type of bonds, there is definitely something that people need to know, because mm-hmm. these initiatives are far complicated, and they write it in a way that is hard yeah. to understand.
Yeah, it is.
You're right. In 2014, there was a water bond mm-hmm. that was Prop 1. That was, I don't remember, it, but I think I had the information somewhere. It was in the 7 billion something, mm-hmm. and 85% of the money has been already allocated.
Okay.
Here you go.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, this was it, 2014. Okay. Yeah.
Then, in this July, already have been 2.7 billion allocated.
Okay.
And then it was 5 point something.
Yeah, 4.8 funds so, will be exhausted by next year.
Exactly.
So you're right, that comes out
so
to 7,
this,
whatever, 7,
this
yeah.
proposed Prop 3 is built basically following the leads of Prop 14.
Okay.
The 2014 water bond. And in fact, it is called the Water Infrastructure Watershed Conservation Bond
okay.
Initiative.
All right.
That's the middle name. The short name is the Water Bond Act of 2018. Okay. In fact, the real name is a very, very long, I cannot even memorize it, but it has to do with water quality, environmental protection, watershed restoration, and all that. And this water bond is definitely an $8.9 billion bond.
Okay.
That will be paid with the general obligation fund. Mm-hmm. During the 40 year of this bond, it will accrue an interest of $8.4 billion.
Okay.
So the total will be in the $17.3 billion that will have to be paid by the general obligation fund.
Okay.
That gives an average of $433 million per year. That's the reason people say, well, this is a tax. But this this bond, the Prop 3, it's it was an initiative process. It was a number of signatures collected. It made it. There was a gentleman named Jerry Merrill, mm-hmm. who was Secretary of Resources in California years ago, and it has really. A portion of funds for everybody
okay.
in the states. That's the reason you will hardly find somebody opposing it, because whether it is water or it is environment, there is a portion for everybody. So El Toro Water District made the decision to support it mm-hmm. because, as you know, El Toro depends completely on imported water.
Right.
And we're limited to the things that we can get from Northern mm-hmm. California and from the Colorado River. So having alternatives to water, to local water, such as recycled water, which is what we have been doing, it is good for us. The reason we cannot do more is because of money. Mm-hmm. But if there is a chance that in the Prop 3 we'll allocate some money to projects that we really want to do, that's the reason we're supporting it. Because there is an opportunity that we may actually be able to fund projects from that. So we adopted a resolution supporting this.
Okay.
I'm not telling anybody you vote for it or
right.
not. I wasn't telling that the board supported. So did a lot of water agencies in California and environmental agencies too. So this has been, over the state, has been a success in terms of support.
Okay.
I don't know of anybody opposing yet.
Okay.
So.
The biggest question I think I would have, and a lot of people have, is like, okay, this is fine if we spend this amount of money over time. If this is going to really help us in drought seasons, is if it's going to move the water around the state and go ahead and beef up our infrastructure, our dams and all this, maybe new water storage areas and things like that for runoff. I think, you know, that's probably the main question people have. Along with that, a lot of people go, well, you know what, we get a lot of bonds for a lot of different things. We never know where the money ends up, and does it move its way into something that has nothing to do with the thing it was supposed to? And you know what I'm talking
yeah.
about.
Well, I know where you're coming from. The truth is that there has been several water bonds. Mm-hmm. In fact, in June we have one, Prop 68, that was called also the water bond and had very little water on it.
Yeah, yes.
It was more towards other aspect of the environment, mm-hmm. But they call it water bond. So they have been using the name of water in vain, basically.
Right, right.
But that's the difference with this water bond. There is real wet water there.
Okay.
So there is enough money there for lots of real projects that produce real water.
Okay.
And that's the reason most of the water agencies are supporting this so far. Comments on the negative, the only concern I have heard from someone is that doesn't include, there is money for everybody, but doesn't include money for surface storage.
Okay. Like
to build reservoirs and dams.
Right.
And the answer from the proponent is, well, there is money for groundwater storage because they think that groundwater storage is actually better.
Okay.
It's not subject to evaporation.
Okay.
There are divided opinions there because to store water in the groundwater, you really have to have certain conditions, which can be met if mm-hmm. there is plenty of money.
Okay.
In general, I think the water bond will allow projects like recycled water, and that's what we have done. Mm-hmm. You know, in El Toro, two years ago, we finished phase one.
Yeah.
It's over 1,200 acre feet of recycled water. We just finished. We're finishing at this moment phase two. It's about 200 and some more acres. We're going to be starting now the retrofit of the connections. So by the end of the year, we'll be actually delivering water to those areas. And to our board meeting, we have customers coming and say, when are you going to be building recycled water in my area?
Mm-hmm.
It is not that we don't like the area, it's that to get the water there is costly.
Right.
And also, we need to have the water.
Mm-hmm.
So costly, if the proposition passes, we're going to have some money,
yeah,
potentially, to do that. And feasible has to be how much water can we recycle.
Okay.
Because remember, with the conservation effort, we have been reducing the recycled water that we can have. The sewer that comes from the houses is not the same.
Right.
So we don't have enough water. Eventually, we will have to do something about it. So,
yeah, that's a very interesting point.
But that's affecting everybody.
Yeah.
And not only the quantity, because now the quality of the sewer is thicker. Mm-hmm. You have the same amount of solid with less water. And this is causing some problems in the pipelines in many areas.
Is that because people are just using less water?
Yes.
So people are doing the right thing, but it also can have kind of a backwards effect.
Exactly.
Interesting.
So there is now a project. Somebody's actually doing some analysis on seeing what happened.
Yeah.
These are the unintended consequences of saving water.
Yeah.
We need to deal with what's happening. And this is sometimes you have to flush two or three times, so you can get rid of whatever.
Yeah,
you
very
have
interesting. There, so. All right, well, very good. This is of course going to be on the ballot in November, and I really appreciate you giving everyone an insight to this because, again, people see bond measures and they go, "Was the money going to go where it's supposed to? How is it going to benefit my area and me personally?" So. Really appreciate it.
Yeah, well, thank you.
Yes, right here.
We have a website in the previous slide that people can go.
Okay, yes. In fact, I actually went on this yesterday, Ballotopia.
Okay. The list of projects that we have here is too long for me to read it.
Yeah, yeah.
So you can tell that there is basically every single project that we know about in California is there. So if you want to know more about it, go and read this proposition. You will see that the amount of money dedicated to water quality, the amount of water conservation, the amount of watershed protection, because this bill also focuses on protecting the waterways, the watersheds, so to maintain the habitat for certain species.
Yeah.
So it is a very comprehensive environmentally and water quality act.
And this is a good website. If you forget the long input there, just go to Ballotopia. .org, and then from there you can put in California Proposition 3. In fact, you can all the propositions, and a lot of things are there. They're non-biased. They do give opinions, but it is opinions of the same thing you get on the ballots. If this group is for, this group is against, that sort of thing. But it's really a neat place to go. I like that website a lot. So, and that's where I found it. That's where I started reading about
Actually.
It. Good to see you, sir, as always. You take care.
Okay, thank you for having us.
And we'll be right back.
Yeah, it's interesting.
Hi, I'm Brian Rott, President and CEO of Cartmart here in Laguna Woods. My family's been in the golf cart business since 1959, and we win our customers over with the simple belief of, we treat you right. We are proud to be the authorized dealer for Club Car here in Orange County, and your go-to source for the sales and service to other major brands. We're conveniently located on El Toro Road, just minutes from Laguna Woods. So come by and see for yourself why when doing business with Cartmart, there's no reason to go anywhere else.
Hi, I'm Wendy Miller, your Laguna Woods real estate professional. Have you been looking for a realtor?
Wendy Miller helped me through the challenging process of real estate here in Laguna Woods. She was helpful, she was fun, she was professional. I really recommend her.
Whether you're thinking of buying, selling, downsizing, or even relocating within Laguna Woods, I am your real estate professional and can help guide you through the entire process. Give me a call and I'll help you make the right move.
Well, you ready to play some golf?
You bet. Just got to take my pills.
I left the house this morning and forgot to take mine. What is that?
MedBox by AmeriPharma has redefined the pharmacy experience. Get all your medications conveniently packaged by the dose every month, regardless of the volume or complexity of your regimen. And best of all, you never miss a dose or worry about when or what you should take next.
This is my lifesaver. My pharmacist organizes all my pills for me and even tells me what time to take them.
Such a hassle for my daughter to organize my medications. But how much does it cost?
Not a penny more. I just called my pharmacist, they contacted my doctor, got my prescriptions, and now I'm all set.
Imagine all of your pharmaceutical service needs in one simple box. It is hassle-free and the service won't cost you a penny more. MedBox by AmeriPharma.
Ray and I are standing in front of a digital sign that we hope serves as a deterrent against speeding vehicles and also just to make our residents aware of their speed wherever they may be. We try to position these throughout our community, around curves, in downhill sections, and again, it's just to remind our folks to take it easy, to watch the posted speed limit. And as you can see here on this one, the posted speed limit is 25 miles an hour. And Ray, I'm sure that you see quite a few speeding violations in your traffic hearings.
Absolutely. We have an average of like 14 people in the morning that come in for traffic, and at least three of the 14 are there for speeding.
There was a speeding vehicle, I believe, driving 37 in a 25, which is excessive. Now, this was a straightaway, but that is unsafe. Just add the additional conditions of maybe it's dark out, poor lighting, the roadways are wet, you're on a curb, you're coming downhill, there's pedestrians out. There's a variety of issues that we need to take into consideration of. Bottom line is, let's take it nice and slow. Be aware of your surroundings. Again, know your limitations. When you're driving fast, you need to be recognize that your ability to brake is going to be severely impacted as well.
After researching all of the golf cart companies in the area, I finally decided on Cartmart to purchase mine, primarily because of their professional attitude, great customer service, friendly people. I've worked with Jared and Tony, who's one of the service people, who's just absolutely phenomenal. I've had a few issues that they took care of with a smile on their face and put a big smile on my face. The prices are competitive. They'll work with you on not only the pricing, but also just on the service part of it. They were the only ones who offered a full 1-year warranty on the cart itself, which was huge for me. especially when you're buying a used one. So other than that, I just think that great place to do business, and that the people are just really nice there. That's what I liked about it the most. Made it easy for me. If you're in the market to buy a golf cart, you owe it to yourself to check out CartMart.
Well, I'd like to welcome with us right now Brian Rott and Gerald Morgan from CartMart. And you know, CartMart right across the freeway at Lake Forest, at least their closest location, because I know there's a few, but that's the easiest one to get to, which is off Schwartz Drive over there. I'd like to welcome you and talk about some specials you have and taking care of your vehicle and all sorts of things, right?
Yeah, thank you. We're happy to be here.
Nice
yeah,
to be
and
here.
I know. Yeah, I know, Brian. You've been here, but this is your first time, sure.
Absolutely.
Right? All right. And you are you the oversee the Lake Forest store?
Absolutely.
Am I right? Okay.
Right on Schwartz.
Yeah. Very good. Great to have you here today.
Thank you, sir.
So let's talk first about, you know, you got any vehicle, even your own bicycle, you got to maintain. But a lot of folks are using these using their carts. Very often, it's their primary vehicle for many people who live here, and they got to be maintained, right? Just like anything else.
Indeed, and that's one of the things about a golf car, especially when it's your major mode of transportation.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the respect you give your golf car has to almost match what you would give your automobile.
Yeah.
And so there's
yeah.
a few tips that we wanted to talk to you guys about to make sure that you're getting the best, longest life out of the car, and real basic maintenance tips like. Since the summer, we had such a hot summer, the batteries in the water in those batteries tend to dissipate faster because of the heat. It
mm-hmm.
actually evaporates that water. So we really recommend that you're spending the time putting distilled water back into your batteries, making sure that the battery terminals are clean and the corrosion free. That's
okay.
a really big thing. That batteries are expensive, and we all know that's one of the most expensive parts to service on a vehicle. If they run out of water, you can basically kill them.
Is that something yeah. that someone can do on their own, or are they sealed batteries? Because I know, like with my vehicle, although I lease, so every 3 years I get a new vehicle, I haven't put water in batteries in yeah. it seems like forever.
Well, the actual service to the vehicle can be done on your own, of
okay.
course. But and a lot of our customers tend to do that work on their own. But of course, if they ever get to a point where they're not feeling comfortable with it, we are more than happy to come to the home, and we provide all that service in your garage or on your, you know, on the street corner, where we're able to take care of all that for you. So if it's too much work on your own, we can handle that. But you know, another thing that's harder to do on your own is maintaining the air pressure in your tires because,
yeah.
again, the air and the heat this summer
yeah.
will tend to impact the condition of the tires over time. And so
mm-hmm.
making sure that there's the right air pressure in those tires to give you the optimum runtime on your car. So a properly serviced tire can actually drive longer and you won't be having the tire issues that are pretty consistent. So
okay, and Gerald, as Brian said, you folks, because let's face it, it's a golf cart, so they can't drive it over there, you know, down the street. I know you do have some that are kind of street legal, but for the average one, they can call you folks up, and you have like a service vehicle that comes out and does everything right there.
We use car services.
Okay.
Oh, I'm sorry, what was the question?
Like to service the golf cart.
Oh, yeah,
you can
yeah.
come
no,
out and do the tire.
Department.
Yeah,
absolutely. We have some of the best techs I've ever seen in my life. They'll come right to your house. They can diagnose, analyze, fix any problem, come right to your house and do it.
Yeah,
absolutely.
I think it'd be a lot easier for folks.
It's a lot easier, absolutely.
Now, can someone, you know, they get a golf cart from you, is there, and I really don't know this, is there like a service plan or a maintenance plan, a yearly thing that they can pay? So,
for sure.
Yeah. Okay.
It's a great way to take the guessing and
yeah,
the scheduling
yeah.
out. So we offer preventive maintenance programs where
We have you pre-scheduled every quarter. Usually for the type of use that happens here in Laguna Woods Village, it's once a quarter or maybe even twice a year. Is enough to make sure that your cart's running in optimal condition. A well-serviced vehicle, well-serviced golf car, can last twice as long, if not longer, than any other one that doesn't that's not serviced, and it holds its value when it's taken care of.
Course. It definitely is, and I know that just because of what I hear about them and how long they last. I mean, they can last a long, long time if you take care of them. I love, on their commercial, they show photos from years ago of the old style golf carts. Yeah. And it's kind of fun to look at those.
Well, if you're really into vintage golf cars and you have the time, our retail store in Rancho Mirage has the National Museum of Golf Cars.
Does it really?
Inside the museum.
That would be fun to see.
It's absolutely amazing. It's wonderful.
Yeah. Now, here's something that I wouldn't think of when it comes to golf carts. Test your brakes and your lights. That's important, too. I wouldn't even think, the battery, the tire pressure, but I wouldn't even think of that.
Well, you imagine you're driving down the street, you're driving these cars in traffic, a lot of times crossing busy streets, and so to have your brakes checked is just about as important as any kind of service check, because there's not a lot of technology in the brake systems. There's some belts, there's some cables or brake pads, but it's not quite set like your automobile. So the brake systems, not to scare anybody, the brake systems can be pretty pretty basic, and so to make sure that you have safe brake, good brake pad thickness, and that everything is tightened and secure, will really make you feel more comfortable as you drive down public streets.
Okay.
And so that's part of our preventive maintenance service, where we can get in and make sure that you've got safe brakes. And chances are 9 out of 10 people haven't checked their brakes since they bought the car.
I think you're probably right. Yeah. Yeah. Now, Jared, I understand you folks have an Uber program.
We use the car service. We understand that some people can't get over to our store across the freeway. I'd like to take credit. It was actually Brian's idea that we call up our store. We'll get you to the store. As soon as you're done shopping, we'll get you home. Take care of everything. Just call us up. We'll get you over there. It's that simple.
It's supposed to make it easy for you. So we realize not everybody has a car in the village here, and so we want to earn your trust in your business by getting you into the store. And the only way we can do that sometimes is to make it super easy. So we'll pick you up. You just got to call us, and we'll send a ride share over to pick you up.
Don't be shy. Call us up
and take you home.
There's the number right there. Hey, you got some special days coming up, and I think one's on September 14th and one on the September 16th. And tell us about these. We got the dates up here.
Right, September 16th is a really fantastic event benefiting Laguna Art Museum. And it's their centennial anniversary.
Nice.
And so Cartmart has partnered with a incredibly famous artist by the name of Kenny Scharf. And Kenny Scharf was a roommate to Keith Haring and Andy Warhol. This is his contemporary. He is probably one of the last and most famous artists of that era and that genre living today. So Kenny Scharf is going to take one of our Polaris gems, and he's going to completely paint it live on stage at September 16th at Laguna Arts Museum. Raffle tickets are $100, and they all go towards winning the cart.
Wow.
And, tickets to the gala are over $1,000 a piece, which is, that event is on the 29th of September.
Yeah.
But if you can make that, it is something.
That'll be fun.
We're big artists in our family, and so we really support the arts community, and we're excited to be partnering with Kenny Scharf for this event, and for $100,
you
have a chance at winning
great.
A cart. To put into perspective, a Kenny Scharf painted golf car would be worth over $150,000.
Wow, that's fantastic. Yeah. Speaking of that, another thing that you folks offer is you can customize golf carts any way you want, right?
Yeah, we make some of the most amazing, incredible custom golf cars. And Jared here in the Laguna Woods store is a master at designing the car down to the pinstripe, or maybe some emblem to reference your something special to you, whether it be a logo or a signage, seating, paint. And that's when we welcome you into the store, because it's so much more fun than having to come in and say, I'll take that one, when you could say, I'd like to build one that makes me happier.
Yeah, and I think that's great. And they have, you know, some of them they have, I call them like, they look like out of the Jetsons. Remember the Jetsons?
Oh, that's okay, my favorite show.
All right.
As a kid.
They're coming out with a movie on that next year. Just a little tip. All right, folks. The website is cartmart.com, and if you'd like to find out more information and get over there, here's their number, 949-597-2094. That's, of course, their Lake Forest office. If you go to cartmart.com, everything's listed there. And Jared can help you out over there.
Absolutely.
And one of these days, we're going to get over there and do a little walk around.
Yeah, we'd love to have you. But in the meantime, we're inviting everybody down to the store today and Monday. We're open Labor Day. We have a $500 off your purchase at our store here with Jared.
Fantastic.
And just come in and see us, and we'd love to meet you.
All right. Great to see you, gentlemen.
Thank
we'll
you,
see
sir.
You again soon. You take care.
Absolutely.
Thank
we'll
you.
We'll be right back.
My name's Greg, and I'm a new resident at Laguna Woods. And one of the things that we noticed after moving in is that many people had a golf cart, and so we wanted to check that out and see what it would be like. And we checked some of the other golf cart places that are around Laguna Woods and weren't as happy as we'd like, so decided to check out Cart Mart. Came over here, met Jared. He was very forthcoming, honest, and showed us what our options were here. We didn't want a brand new one. And we really liked the club car that he showed us and bought it and have really enjoyed it. He talked to us about how to make it more customized to what we wanted. They delivered it to my home in Laguna Woods and showed us how to use it, and we were very happy with the customer service.
Summer is here. Diane's Hallmark has everything you need to make summer cool. From clothing to jewelry to unique one-of-a-kind gifts, Diane's Hallmark is the place to go. Diane's also has a large religious section as well. Come in today to see it all. Diane's Hallmark is located in the Walmart Shopping Center next to Hobby Lobby.
Dental health is important, and it can be tough to find the best fit for your needs. Flora Stenger General and Specialty Dental Practice covers most of my dental needs in one location. Their on-staff specialists provide seamless services and communication between me, my doctors, and my insurance company. Located right down the road from Laguna Woods, our bus service stops right in front of their building. For the first time, I'm getting the dental care I need with the treatment I deserve. And my dental health has never been better. Call and book your first appointment today. I'm glad I did.
And our movie coming up today is Overboard. This is a remake of the old Goldie Hawn, Kurt Russell movie this time around. It stars Anna Faris in that role. Also, Eugene Debras is in this, and Eva Longoria. And great cast in this. Obviously, this is a very funny movie, and it deals with this woman, Anna Faris here, who works for this wealthy man on the yacht, and the way she's treated, and all the different things that go on. A funny movie. If you remember the original one, this pretty much follows it. There's a little bit of different takes in there, but good funny movie. And that will be on today at 2 o'clock and at 7 o'clock, Overboard. Our Monday movie is kind of become a classic now, March of the Penguins. This came out back in 2005. Of course, it's narrated by Morgan Freeman. And it follows the trek of a group of emperor penguins that trek the South Pole every single year to their hatching grounds, really. And interesting that when it comes to the emperor penguins, it is the male penguin that sits on the egg over a period of time and hatches it while the female goes out and gets food. And they actually are, from what I understand, they're the male and female mates. They stick together. So kind of like, a lot of different ducks and things like that too, but they're monogamous. So it's a very touching story. And we've shown this to you once before, so I think you will really enjoy this. And maybe sometime in the future, the March of the Penguins 2 came out recently. We can bring you that one as well. All right, let me get you to the weather. And again, I've got a couple days of warmer weather because of a high pressure system that is off our coast, not inland, which is a little bit different. That's why we're still getting the evening offshore, or I should say onshore breezes, which is nice. So that's why, the temperatures are up a little bit, but the overnights are staying about the same. We're going to drop that down probably Monday and Tuesday as we get that marine layer back, which is nice. At least that's where in the forecast, you know, that could change just depending on this high pressure system. And as I said earlier, you know, we get into the end of September and October, often those are our warmest months. And unfortunately, when we start getting those dangerous Santa Ana winds. Around the state this weekend, looking pretty darn good. Everywhere you go, up in the North Coast, it'll be cool up there. Everywhere else, though, mild to warm weather and just looking very, very good, very pleasant weather. So you folks have a great weekend, a great Labor Day. We are off on Labor Day, so we will see you on Tuesday. Take care.